Welcome, this is How to HubSpot, I'm Thomas. I spent the past couple of weeks playing around with HubSpot's marketing automation software, and I found some pretty cool stuff that I'm excited to teach you today. You can get started with our marketing automation software demo for free in the link in the description below. In this video, I'm gonna demonstrate the basics of lead nurturing and also how to build a lead nurturing email campaign within HubSpot. Let's go. Lead nurturing sits in the third of five stages in the lead management process. The five stages of the lead management process are number one, lead generation. Number two, lead qualification and segmentation. Number three, lead nurturing. Number four, lead scoring and lead routing. And lastly, number five, measurement of success. During the lead nurturing process, it's super critical to make sure that you're addressing your prospects' needs and goals instead of just blasting out emails to all these unqualified leads. All right, let's go ahead and start mapping out our lead nurturing email campaign within HubSpot. For this example, let's say I own a golf apparel company. Let's call it Thomas Golf. And I'm aiming at folks that are looking for affordable luxury golf apparel. Let's say our summer line has done very well and we're excited about our fall line coming soon. So we want to start a lead nurturing campaign to promote this new fall line and make sure our customers know what's coming soon, as well as to entice potential new customers to purchase. There are four steps to creating a lead nurturing campaign in HubSpot. Number one, develop a strategy. Number two, create your content. Number three, build your emails. And number four, set up your workflow. Just a side note though, it's important that even though you're using these four steps, you wanna make sure that you're not just blasting out emails and you wanna send these emails over time to nurture your prospects all throughout the buying process. So your first email, for example, will be during awareness. Second will be during consideration. And third, during the decision. Number one, strategy. Your strategy should have three key points. The first key point, a goal. So for my example, I'd want 15% of my leads that have entered the campaign to convert into sales within 3 months. The next key point is identifying your buyer persona to target, AKA a semi-fictional character that represents your ideal customer. My example is weekend golfer Billy, age 35, occupation, marketing manager, makes about $105,000, hobbies are golf and fitness, and his challenges are limited shopping time and finding affordable luxury clothes that fit well. And for the final key point, we have to map out our persona's buyer's journey. This will help you build your content and messaging strategies later. So for Billy, in the awareness stage, he scrolls on Instagram and sees a lot of golf posts. In the consideration stage, he then researches products, checks reviews, and signs up for a discount. And lastly, in the decision stage, now that he has that discount, he purchases with confidence. And now that we have our strategy mapped out, it's time to create your website content. As mentioned previously, you'll need to create content that is specifically tailored to each stage of the buyer journey. So in the awareness stage, some examples are ebooks, blogs, or how-to videos. For my example, I have a blog about why name brands are dying in the golf apparel industry. Next is the consideration stage. Some examples are comparison guides or case studies. For my example, I have a photo shoot highlighting the summer line featuring reviews from customers. And finally, the decision stage. Some examples are free trials, live demos, or coupons. In my case, I'll be offering a fall pre-order coupon. All right, we've created our content with consideration to each stage in the buyer journey. Now it's time to build those emails. Your emails will be the main source to deliver your content to your leads. As mentioned earlier, you'll send out emails slowly during each stage of the buyer journey to guide them to that all-important conversion. Use action-oriented words, personalization, provide CTAs in the emails, and emphasis on branding. Side note here, emphasizing on branding is pretty important, so make sure to lean in on your brand colors, custom email header images that stay consistent, and developing that company-based lingo to greet customers. All right, now the foundation is set and we've built our content, it's time to build our workflow. Okay, so to create a workflow, we're gonna go down to automations, workflows. In the upper right-hand corner, click Create Workflow from scratch. Then we're gonna choose contact-based, blank workflow, hit Next. All right, we wanna name this workflow Fall 2024 Lead Nurturing. So how are people going to get into this nurture? We need to set up some triggers. For the first trigger, we wanna select when an event occurs. Then we're gonna type in form submissions, hit save. We're targeting current customers who have filled out purchase forms and any leads that have filled out any sort of form. Now, for the first action, we're going to hit that plus button, go down to communications, send an email. We've already pre-made all three of our lead nurturing emails. So at this point, we're just gonna select from this list. Lead nurturing email number one. So in this email, we're addressing the awareness stage, and I'll include that blog that I mentioned earlier about why brand names are dying in the golf industry. Click save. And like I mentioned earlier, we don't wanna just blast out emails to our prospects. We wanna go about it in a very methodical approach, so we're gonna space these emails out. So for our next action, we're gonna add a delay. Click on delay, then set amount of time, and we're gonna go 7 days. You do have the option, however, if you wanna be very precise about it, to do hours and minutes. Hit save. Next, we're gonna send our next email. So go to communications, send email, and we're gonna choose our lead nurturing email number 2. This email will address the consideration stage, and it includes the photo shoot that we took, as well as the customer reviews. So hit save, wonderful. And then again, we'll add another delay, continuing that nurturing process into the final stage, which is the decision stage. So add your delay, click on set amount of time, and we'll do this about 4 days. 4 days sounds right. And finally, we're now gonna set up our decision stage email. Send email, lead nurturing email number 3, and in this email, it's gonna contain the coupon and the CTA. Great, so hit save and we're ready to go. All right, now we've mapped out each email that addresses each stage of the buyer's journey. As you can see, it's a very simple process, but before we set this campaign into motion, we wanna set up our goals. Remember earlier, my goal was to convert 15% of leads that enter the campaign to convert to customers within 3 months. So how do we do that? What we're gonna do is go into edit and edit goal. And just to reiterate, what we're trying to do here is to make sure that these leads that have filled out a form will then exit the nurturing campaign and become actual customers, which we can track within that 3 month period. So click contacts, meet a goal, contact properties, and we're gonna search life cycle stage. Perfect, click that. And is any of, and it needs to be customer. That looks good, apply filter. Then we'll click and contact properties, scroll down until you see became a customer date. And this is where we wanna make sure that it's before that 3 month threshold in my goal, so is before. And we're gonna do the end of November because that's typically when the golf season ends. So that'll be November 30th, 2024. That looks great. And we can apply filter and then we can save. Now that we've set up our goal, we're able to view the performance as the time goes by. If you click on view, performance, on the top metrics section, on the right-hand side, you can see goal conversion rate. All right, so at this point, my company is ready to send out our fall nurturing campaign and ready to convert those leads and achieve our goals. As you can see, creating content and setting up email workflows is pretty easy with HubSpot. If you'd like to learn more about workflows and boost efficiency, make sure to check out our marketing automation software demo for free using the link in the description below. Let us know in the comments as well if there are any other features you'd like to learn about. Well, that's it for me. I'm Thomas. Catch you in the next one.